Michelle Dunbar, mm-hmm. and her father, David, and
Toria.
So,
and sister.
And friends. I think we have friends here too. I actually met Michelle in March at a conference for SPAN. I also work for SPAN as well. And so she did a wonderful, just very moving presentation. And I said to the family, you guys have to come and speak to our district about your amazing story. So I'm really excited to have Michelle here to tell her story.
Welcome. Thank you. My name is Michelle Vinnicur. I'm 19 years old and I have autism. I was born in Brooklyn, New York. I was diagnosed with autism on my mom's birthday, 10 days before my second birthday in the year 2000. Growing up in Brooklyn, my autism affected me in many ways. I had no eye contact, I didn't respond to anyone who called my name, and I was nonverbal. I didn't like anyone to touch me, more like anyone picking me up. I had temper tantrums. I liked everything in the routine. I was isolated from my siblings, my older sister Samantha, and my younger brother John. I didn't engage with anyone pretty much, and I was in my own world. When I was 3 years old, and in August of 2001, my family and I moved to Marlborough, New Jersey. My parents were looking for a good school for me as soon as we moved to Marlborough, and they found Children's Center of Monmouth County. It's a school in Neptune, New Jersey for students with autism and multiple disorders. I was in a secluded classroom with students who had autism like me, and the school did not provide any educational studies. It was mostly about life skills. I was the only girl in the class, and the rest were boys. I did not have many memories from being in Children's Center, but I do remember the Hawaiian dance I did with my second grade teacher, Ms. Lauren, because we practiced so much that I still remember that thing. Later on, my parents found out from the school that I was more advanced than most of my classmates. They said I was verbally communicating and my behavior improved. My parents weren't convinced at first, but for me, I knew I was ready for the world. And when we found out that I was already verbally communicating and like my behavior, that we were going to my school's town district, and we went to go visit a public school in the district in June of 2006. So we went inside a school building. It was with my dad, and we went to visit the principal and one of the teacher aides I was going to have in the future, which I had in the future, Ms. Rossman. Then I remember being walked to the classroom, and inside the classroom, I remember that I had a desk with a name tag on it, and there was a blue notebook with my name on it too. And I met with my future teacher, Ms. Twenger. I was shy around the other students in the class during my visit that day, but I was just so happy being in the class. My first real school that I went to was Frank Dugan Elementary School. September 2006 was when I started Frank Dugan Elementary School. I was still in a minibus as my transportation. I remember being scared about my first day in a new school. I was very shy, and I never knew how to make friends. Attending Dugan entailed new challenges for me. I was in a small classroom filled with 15 students, less than 15 students, including me. I was in the lowest resource class for math and English, because I didn't receive educational studies before. I was in a regular classroom for science and social studies. It was very different being in a regular classroom because there was more students, but I did have a teacher's aide in the classroom. I was pulled out from one-on-one classroom assistance in different subjects. And during my one-on-one sessions, my teacher assistant went over any topics that I needed clarification. She also reviewed and helped me prepare for any upcoming tests. During my math class in my resource classroom, I was allowed to use a number line system to assist me when working on math problems. Another one of my accommodations that I used was to be allowed to sit in front of the classroom, as I still do today. I received a number of therapies by the child study team in Duke. They include physical, speech, and occupational therapy. I still remember when I first learned to hold a pencil, because it reminds me of when I learned and began to write. big milestone for me. I'm very proud of that. I believe that being in a regular school, surrounded by supportive teachers and students, really helped me achieve many of my goals. I was also eligible for extended school trip. The child study team from Dugan and Special Services Administration allowed me to attend a camp for special needs children over the summer, since there were no appropriate summer school accommodations for me in the district. They recommended to me a camp called Harbor Haven. The camp was only 10 minutes away from my home, and I liked the camp so much that I ended up going there for 4 summers. It was a fun experience for me. I still remember my group of friends that I was with in camp. I got educational activities while having fun activities too. Parents, always ask your child's study team about extending the school year and other possible options for your child. When I was going into 4th grade, I transferred to Robertsville Elementary School. I still had the same teacher and all the same accommodations, but our class had to move due to space issues. It was definitely a challenge for me adjusting to a new school again, but I got through the support of my family and teachers. I stopped having physical and occupational therapy when I was in 4th grade. I improved so much that I only needed speech therapy. I knew I was improving because I was getting better at pronouncing words during speech therapy. After ending my elementary school years, I attended Marble Middle School. It was the first time I ever attended a school with my siblings. I finally started taking the big bus with the other neighborhood kids. I was so excited about going on the big bus. But middle school was a big adjustment for me, though. I struggled in sixth grade with things like using a locker. I had difficulty opening my locker since it was a combination lock. I used to get frustrated about it. I had difficulty opening my locker since it was a combination lock. I told my parents and we talked to the child study team, and my accommodations were made to use a key to open my locker. I used the key to open my locker throughout all my middle school years. It made me feel better and less anxious. I want to let everyone know, do not be afraid to ask for any accommodations for anything, even if it's for as simple as using a key for your locker. I was showing so much improvement in school, my mom signed me up for Taekwondo classes at ATA Black Belt Academy. My mom wanted me to learn self-defense because it would help me improve my motor skills and self-control. It turned out to be my favorite activity of all time. I will never forget my experience there. I was one of the couple of students with a disability that was put into regular Taekwondo classes. It showed to me that I was able to perform like everyone else, even though I learned differently. And successfully, I earned my black belt when I was 10 years old. It was in December 2009. My older sister Samantha and I earned our black belts the same day. It showed that having autism did not stop me from earning my black belt. Today I feel so strong and more confident in life because I had the opportunity to do something like to perform like everyone else. Throughout middle school, I continued to receive accommodations like speech and teacher's aid in the classroom. In 6th grade, I attended all resource classrooms. In 7th grade, I moved up to a regular math class with a teacher's aide. My teacher aide was there to assist me if I needed any clarification. And what I used to do is that I always would use to raise my hand. My teacher aide was also available during lunch for any extra help I needed. By 8th grade, I moved up to all regular classes except for science. My parents and I continued to meet with a child study team once a year to go over my progress and review any accommodations I may need. One of my accommodations was to have extra time on tests and only 2 choices instead of 4 choices on multiple choice tests. And I was also allowed to have test questions read to me if I needed them. And also, and furthermore, I had an influential speech teacher in middle school. Her name is Ms. Smith. At first, I only had Ms. Smith for my speech therapy during middle school, but then by the time I was in 8th grade, she created a social skills class for students with special needs. And I used to attend there once a week, and we would go over social conversation, and as well as with making friends. And I improved tremendously with my social skills. Because of the social skills class, I was able to make my own group of friends at lunch in the 8th grade. And they are still my best friends today. Thank you. The social skills class helped me learn how to be around people in various situations. After graduating middle school, I attended Colstead High School. I received a sibling waiver to attend Colstead with my older sister because she was a student there. My parents thought it was a good idea for me to go to a school with someone that can help me if I needed it. My first month as a freshman in high school was difficult, though. It turned out that the school never received any of my IEP files, and they had no idea that I was classified and that I need special accommodations. I was having anxiety over the issues in school, and I told my parents that I was having difficulty. So what we did was that we called my guidance counselor to set up an appointment to talk about my disability and to get any accommodations that I needed. And then also after having a meeting with the child study team case manager and psychologist, Mr. Schaefer, all the issues were resolved and I started getting all the necessary accommodations that I needed. My first month of high school proved to me that my parents were always there to support me and get all the resources that I needed to do well in school. During my high school years, I received all the same services that I was getting in elementary school and in middle school, like speech, teacher's aid, and I got longer test times. I always reached out to my teachers for assistance if I needed extra help. Being in the regular school taught me how to advocate for things that I needed, it taught me how to reach out to my teachers and not being afraid to ask for help. After overcoming my personal issues and adjusting to regular classes, in my last 2 years of high school, I became a peer mentor for students with various disabilities in an after-school program called Cooper Connections. We did activities like from arts and crafts and also to attending our school sports events. I inspired the students about overcoming my personal issues while being a good friend for them too. My biggest decision came to me when I was in my senior year of high school. I chose to stop my speech therapy that I had gone since I was very young. I knew I was doing really well at this point in my life, both socially and in community. In addition, I knew there wouldn't be any therapies in college. I was proud to have made my own decision because it was proving to me that I was becoming independent in my decisions, being self-advocate, and knowing what I needed. Last year in June, I graduated from Colstead High School with 4 principal honors, getting straight A's, being in National Honor Society, Academic Student of the Month, and 2 awards from Senior Awards Night. I also attended the Dare to Dream Leadership Conference as a keynote speaker. Today, I currently attend Brookdale Community College. I passed through my first whole year of Brookdale. And I owe my success to the disability services provided by Brookdale Community College. I registered through the disability services provided from the college. I got to talk with the case manager, Ernest Overson, and I chose what accommodations met with my needs. My accommodations are listed on this paper that's called an alert form. Every class I take, I provided with the professors I was going to have with my alert form. And we discuss any accommodations that I may need. My professors are very accommodating. Brookdale Community College also offers students with special needs a vocational program called CATCH. The students get job career experience there while also getting classroom experience. Parents, encourage your child to go to college. There are many programs and resources for your child so that they can succeed in college. Lastly, I want to share today that I drive, I attend college, and I have a job. I would not be here speaking to all of you if it wasn't for my supportive parents and great school systems. To all families and teachers, do not give up and have high expectations for your special child's special skills. Thank you.